Hi, Sam here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and I'm here today with this brilliant, well-trusted, well-loved overdrive pedal, the Boss Blues Driver, or the BD2. Now, this is a staple of many a guitarist's pedal board. This marks the 25th year of this pedal being out. We think that's around about 1995. And this is just a fantastic overdrive. It kind of embodies the element of a nice clean breakup to full saturation and everything in between. So let's have a look at the basic core tone that I'm using. Now, a lot of people ask what we're running through. At the moment, I've just got my guitar going into the pedal, into an orange amp with a clean channel, and it sounds like this. So as you can hear, that's super clean sounding and no breakup at all from the amp. It's quite a nice pedal platform to have a high headroom amp, and often that's the kind of perfect environment for a pedal like this. So let's just start off looking at the core sounds. So I'm going to set everything to about midday. So we've got a level, we've got a tone and a gain, and of course, like all classic Boss pedals, we just press it and on it goes. At the moment we're running on battery power, so we're just going to listen to it with this tone. I'm going to go on the neck pickup of this guitar, which is a single coil, and I'm going to turn my volume all the way up on that guitar and just show you how the breakup is. So as you can hear, that's a nice classic kind of breakup sound, nice mid-rangey. You can hear all the detail and tone. Now, leaving the settings like that, if I use my volume control on the guitar, I can just show you how clean it goes. So here's the volume, like around 3 on my guitar, same settings. It's great for dynamic lead playing. So if I want to play, I'm going to sort of improvise around now with different pick attacks and different volume control, but still leaving everything at midday on the pedal. So starting with a nice sort of mellow vibe. Love it. It's just so organic with the tone. There's lots of sustain as well in the fingers, even with the volume up. I can still do all those kind of shreddy licks and stuff, but I've still got that dynamic range of tone that sounds really nice and musical. Now, having said that, in that intro demo and later on as well, as you'll hear, I also changed the drive level, and it really does scream. So I'm just going to actually show you this on full. Okay, then we're going to do some more subtle settings, but just to show you the intensity of this pedal, I'm going to back the volume off just a little bit to level it out. And hopefully our levels are okay. And here it is on full bore. So as you can hear, there's terrifying amounts of sustain. It's very saturated sounding. It's great for those burning sort of single note leads, fattening them up. But if I roll the volume back on the guitar still with this extreme gain setting, you can hear, it really responds well to the volume and the pick attack. And that gain control can be changed, you know, to where you want to use it, of course. We also have the tone control. Let's just have a listen just to how interactive that is. What I'm going to do is I'm going to sort of dial the gain back a little bit just before sort of noon, so we can get this kind of tone. And I'm going to get to the bridge pickup so we can really hear this difference. As you can hear, you can really get a whole range of shades of tone in the upper mid range to treble range and how much you hear from the drive. I mean, out of the box, just on the mid level, I could just put that on my board right now and I'd be able to get through a gig with that. It's just, you can see why it's so popular for so many years, of the 25 years it's been around. Many players are very famous for using this in different ways. It works fantastically straight into a clean amp and using it as your kind of main drive sound, or just using it to sweeten up a clean amp if you're going around borrowing backline and you've got a clean amp and you want to get a kind of core tone. And if you can get comfortable with a Boss driver, and this is the thing that's fantastic about Boss, is wherever you are in the world, you're probably going to find the Blues driver pedal or other Boss pedals like this. And if you can get your tone out of it and get your sound happy, you needn't be worried about where you are and not having the right gear, because there will always be one of these around. Such a great pedal to have in your arsenal. It can be also used as a boost as well if you want to boost other pedals with it. Andy Timmons is famous for boosting his sort of more high gain overdrives with this pedal, with the gain down, just to get a super nice saturated sound with a unique mid-range. And also using it for his kind of cleaner tones and rolling off as well. He uses a multitude of pedals, but this one has been the one he's often spoken about in interviews, and who doesn't love Andy Timmons? So that is the Boss Blues Driver 2, the BD2. 25 years, it's solid, it's got golden knobs, it's just amazing. You gotta check one out if you haven't already checked one out. I want another one. I want my whole board to be full of Blues Drivers, because they're all brilliant. So yeah, Boss Blues Driver, and yeah, Sam Bell here for Guitar Interactive Magazine. Enjoy.